Luke and Laura's romance captivated viewers as no daytime story had ever done before. Capture the adventure, the intrigue, and the passion. Luke and Laura's romance had a most unusual beginning. Luke's sister Bobby wanted Laura's boyfriend Scotty for herself. She called on Luke to do a little dirty work and break them up.
Oh, I know that look, Bobby. I'd hate to be on the receiving end. Okay. What do you want me to do about her?
I want her sent off to reform school. That's where she belongs, and that's where she'd be if her parents weren't famous doctors with big, expensive lawyers to pull strings and get her off. What? What's so funny?
Oh, baby, you got the wrong number.
What?
Look, I got no pull with the juvenile court. Look, you want her roughed up a little bit? I talked to a couple of the boys here about that.
No. Will you listen? I got a plan.
Signed, sealed, and delivered.
Are you sure everything?
There ain't no mechanic up here in the boondock is ever gonna figure out what I did to that carburetor.
Maybe we should call for help before it gets any later.
We can't. We're right in the middle of nowhere.
Well, Scotty, we can't just stand here. I knew it. I knew it. I'm gonna miss my curfew.
Hey, Scotty. How you doing? You remember me, Luke Spencer? I'm taking a couple of classes here.
Luke, this is Laura Weber. Luke Spencer and my roommate, Brian Phillips.
Hey, how you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Well,
nice to meet you too, Laura.
Thank you.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
She is beautiful, isn't she?
That she is.
She's even prettier than her pictures in the newspaper.
The scheme to break up Scotty and Laura obviously failed.
All of us here pray that your marriage will be a source of abundant happiness for you, and that you will enrich it by your tender devotion, your mindfulness in little things, and most importantly, by your patience and your constancy with one another, today and forever.
This is the first wedding I've ever been to where I didn't cry. I didn't shed a tear.
Really? And Scotty and I tried so hard to work it out so that there wouldn't be a dry eye in the house, didn't we?
Luke Spencer is a child of the streets. He will always be reaching to get himself out of the gutter. He carries the streets in his heart and will never escape them, really.
Luke was managing the campus disco along with Bobby's new boyfriend, Roy DeLuca. The disco was a front for the head of the mob, Frank Smith. Running the disco offered Luke tremendous prestige and offered something to Laura as well, a job.
So what can I do for you?
Is it true that you're looking for help in the disco?
Yeah.
Then I'm applying.
You mean Laura Weber Baldwin wants to wait tables?
Anything wrong with it?
No. There's a lot right with it from where I'm standing.
And I'm saying you can just forget the disco.
I've already accepted, and Luke expects me there tonight.
Oh, yeah? Well, you get on the phone and you call him and tell him to forget it. Because if you don't, I will.
Terrific. Well, that's just terrific. You face it, Scotty. You want the money that I earn, but you also want to choose how I will earn it.
What the heck are you trying to prove?
that I can make up my own mind.
I don't see her as ever having been a teenager. She had such a difficult life that her childhood was ripped right out of her hands.
I'd like to help you now if I can. Tell me what kind of trouble you in. Maybe I can help. I mean, all you have to do is tell me.
You're really quite wonderful, you know.
I'm not sure what I am sometimes, except for really confused.
I never met anybody like you before.
And you probably never will again.
Yeah, you're joking, but I'm serious. I probably won't.
But tell me now, seriously, is there anything I can do to help?
May I tell you something?
Sure.
Your relationship with Scotty, it gives me hope that I can have a better life myself someday.
Of course you can.
Yeah, well, I can if I can find someone like you.
That'll be easy. Believe me, there are plenty of girls around like me.
No, there aren't. You know, see, it's been my life and Bobby's. It's been like we always have to settle for second best, you know, and I'm sick of that. I don't want to have to do that anymore.
I don't think you should. What's more, I don't think you have to. You know, you're a pretty special person, Luke. You never let anyone down, ever.
No, I never let anybody down.
Frank Smith saw an opportunity in Luke Spencer to take a young street punk and groom him for bigger things. Bigger things being work with the mob. And because Luke was and is and remains greedy for success and material things and all of the comforts that he never had as a child, Smith saw an opportunity in him to create a lieutenant, if you will.
Luke's first assignment was to kill Senator Mitch Williams.
And then maybe they'll decide to test our loyalty. Maybe they'll ask us to take care of Mitch Williams.
I'm gonna tell it to you straight, partner. I can't do that.
No, I'm going to give it to you straight, partner. If they tell us to waste Mr. Williams and we don't do it, they're going to be somebody to waste us like that.
What's your answer, kid?
When do you want it to happen?
November 6th, election night. It's really a beautiful rifle, Luke. It was removed from a shipment, so it can't be traced.
Yes, we're sending Mitch off first class.
Piece will be fixed so it doesn't take fingerprints, has a 6-power scope. You'll be taking him from about 72 yards. You can't miss. He'll be right in the spotlight. Don't try for the head, Luke. It's an uncertain target. Go for the body. If you don't hit the heart, don't worry. Hit him in the chest. He'll be gone.
What if I miss him?
I'd be very disappointed in you, Luke.
I wasn't crying.
Yes, you were. When you didn't know that I was here. Luke, you've always been there for me. Why won't you treat me like that kind of a friend?
I don't want you involved, Laura.
Please, Luke, I want to help you.
You can't.
Luke, I'm sure that whatever it is, it can be worked out in time.
Time is what I don't have.
don't understand.
Within the month, I'll be dead.
Your life isn't over.
Don't you hear me? I said I was going to be dead, killed, little lady. What's the matter? Can't you get that through your head? Now get out of here.
Look, I don't know what you're talking about.
That's always been the trouble, you know. You never could. And you didn't know. You've never known where I was coming from, have you?
I know. I know that you care about me.
Damn it, Laura! I'm in love with you.
No, I don't think it's really love, Luke.
Yes. Yes, that's what it is. And it's like some kind of sickness inside me. It's eating me up. I can't concentrate on anything. And in my business, that's dangerous, baby. You got me between two worlds that don't mix.
I don't know what you're talking about, but I think I better...
That's right. You can't understand it. Why can't you understand me, Laura? I know why. Because you have Scotty. Do you know what it does to me? To know that you're in his bed every night. Do you know that all I care about is holding you? I need you. All I do is dream about you. I dream about holding you in my arms and making love to you. Laura, you are my life.
Now, I know that you feel like your life is falling apart right now, and I'm sorry. But we can help you. Scotty and I are your friends.
Don't say that ever again, okay? Look, I don't want to be your friend, Laura. I don't want to be your friend, and I can't have you. You don't belong in my world. I don't belong in yours. Look what you've done to me. I'm not gonna die without holding you in my arms just one time. Dance with me, Laura.
No.
I said, dance with me.
A complex attraction, a desperate man, a moment of madness.
Look, I have to go now. Luke, let me call a taxi, please. You're frightening. No. No. Oh, Luke, let me go.
Just telling a very interesting story, a story of two people caught in a web of passion and desire, and while the woman was victimized by the man was also victimized by the man. I felt a great responsibility to deliver the story and also to make sure that that Genie as a person was okay.
He did not want to do anything to me, Genie, that would hurt me or be scary for me. And I remember he came to me in the rehearsal hall and he said, "Let's move away and talk." Well, nobody ever said that to me at that time. Nobody ever asked me how I felt. So already, I mean, I felt so safe with him.
Laura never told her husband it was Luke who raped her. Both she and Luke were tormented by the event, though they continued to work together. Laura tried to get on with her life, But Luke realized his was coming to an abrupt end.
I don't understand.
I won't touch you. I swear I won't touch you.
Okay.
I just need to talk to you. I need to say goodbye to you.
Goodbye?
Yeah, that's all.
Why?
Because this is the end of the line for me tonight, Laura, and you won't be seeing me anymore.
Luke.
And I just have this need to talk to you. Tonight I have this job that I have to do after I take you home, and it's a job that's going to end everything for me. I just want you to know that you're the only one good thing that I ever had in my life. And I'm really sorry that I hurt you, because I didn't mean to do that. Laura, it's been killing me inside, inch by inch, knowing what I did to you. To know that I could do that to any woman, but to do it to you. I got a job to do. Let's get out of here. Get in the car.
Can I turn the radio on?
Sure. What are you doing?
I'm gonna keep you from doing this job. That's what I'm doing.
You idiot! You just put a bullet in my head! Look, listen to me. I don't want to have to get you mixed up in this, but I have no choice. I've got to reach Roy before he does something stupid.
I will do anything.
All right, get in your car and get up here and pick me up. Don't waste time. Just hang up and get in your car. Roy's going to get killed unless I get to him first. Roy just accepted my place in a suicide mission. Yeah. There's a contract out on Mitch Williams' life. I'm supposed to kill him. Roy thinks he's doing me a big favor by taking over for me. He doesn't realize it's all over for me anyway.
What do you mean that it's all over for you?
I've been a dead man, Bobby, for a long time now, ever since I accepted this job. And now Roy's going to be dead, too, unless we get there fast.
Roy's death bought Luke a second chance with the mob, and perhaps with Laura.
There is so much unfinished business between us, Laura. Still.
I'm going home to my husband, and I never want to see you again. I just want to forget the whole thing, okay?
I don't have to tell you it'll never happen again, Laura, because there will never be another opportunity.
No, there won't.
And don't worry. I won't come near you again.
Thank you for everything, Luke. I can't tell you what it's meant to me.
I believe in you, Luke, but yes, you do need more experience, good contacts, good exposure. That's why I'm considering putting you in your own club in Vegas for a while. Are you interested?
Well, of course I'm interested.
I think someone was listening to our whole conversation from Luke's office closet.
What makes you say that?
I saw some shadows moving under the door.
There's one girl I'm curious about.
Who is that?
Laura Baldwin, the girl who came out of your office a while ago.
What about her?
Who is she really, Luke? I mean, who is she to you?
Well, she's a girl who works here. She did work here, actually. This was her last night. I just gave her her final check. Why do you ask?
I think there must be some kind of mix-up. Tonight wasn't Laura Baldwin's last night working here. You see, Luke, a girl like that can be a real asset to us, to this place. So you get her back here, working.
Well, I'll try, Mr. Smith.
No, Luke, you'll do it, or else. We want her here, where we can keep an eye on her.
Laura, you're gonna have to play this my way. You have to know now this was not a trick to get you back to the disco so I could be near you. Please trust me. I'm asking you to trust me with your life. Laura. Laura.
I trust you. I have to.
That's all I can ask. Laura, I won't let Frank Smith or anyone harm you.
Jennifer's looking forward to the opening. I hope you are, too.
Oh, very much.
Speaking of my daughter, I had a very interesting conversation with her last night. I had no idea your relationship with Jennifer had progressed so far.
She's a wonderful lady.
And you're a fine young man, Luke. But to use an old-fashioned expression, I just want to make certain that your intentions are honorable.
Oh. Well, my intentions are honorable enough to make sure that Jennifer doesn't make a mistake, sir. She's very young, and she is vulnerable, despite her sophisticated talk.
You read her very well. And, of course, I don't want you to make a mistake either. But I know that you're smart enough to realize that an alliance with the family would only do good to your career.
Yes, I'm sure.
I see big things ahead for you with me and the organization. Believe me, Luke, I'm quick to reward as well as to punish.
To stay in favor with the mob and protect Laura, Luke agreed to marry Frank Smith's daughter. Laura was jealous, and one night Luke got Laura to admit her true feelings for him.
Is it true that when you see Jennifer and me together, you want to scream? When you think about her being my wife, my marrying her, my making love to her, that makes you sick.
I just don't want to see you marry another girl to protect me.
You don't want to see me marry another girl because you don't want another woman to have me.
No, no, that's not true.
Listen, I know you love your husband. I know you love Scott, but you can't tell me that there aren't nights when you lay in that bed and turn over and touch him and wish that he were me and wish that I was holding you and wish that I was making love to you, Laura.
Please, Luke.
Laura, doesn't that precious truth that you claim you want so much, doesn't it tell you anything? Doesn't it tell you that you're in love with me? You need me. Doesn't it tell you? I won't touch you unless you want me to. But Laura, you have to say the words. I love you. I love you. I want to hold you in my arms. Take this.
Key?
Key to the door, you're free to go. Go on, go. Go tell Scott that that night in the disco was rape.
I thought the door to that cabin was jammed, and so help me God, I wanted you to make love to me then and there. Please, stay away from me, please. I have so many feelings. Right now, I just can't handle it.
Oh, I understand that. I understand having feelings.
I still love my husband. And I still want to stay married to him. You and I weren't meant to be together, Luke. Your life is so foreign to me. I am begging you. Please. Stay away from me, okay? I'll stay away from you. You marry Jennifer. You make a life with her. Don't try to be any part of mine.
What appeals to me most about Laura is that she is so human. She wants, obviously she's a good girl. She wants very badly to do the right thing all the time. But she can't. You know, she was a very flawed person. You know, she gave into her lust and she gave into her pride. They caused her a lot of problems. But she always wanted to do the right thing and struggled. And I like that about her. I like how human she was.
Dear Luke, just as you tried to set me free in your Christmas letter to me, I want to give you your freedom on your wedding day. Since the night you raped me,
our lives have been bound together by all the lies that had to be told.
The guy that raped you.
Please, God, you've got to listen to me.
To what, Laura? To more lies?
No.
How could you have lied to me all this time? You knew it was Luke. Well, you two have been having an affair.
Give me the protection I need, and nobody will ever see these pictures.
I don't care how many pictures you took with my black book. They won't do you any good. You walk out of this wedding and cause me any more trouble, you're a dead man.
Who's party?
Knows too much, Robin.
We'll find him, sir. And if he's alive?
I know he isn't. But if he is, make sure he doesn't stay that way.
Help me, please. Help me!
Anybody around?
There's a police car in the parking lot.
You finally told him, didn't you?
No, I didn't tell him, Luke.
Of course you did.
No, I didn't.
Then why did he come after me?
He found the letter that I wrote to you.
Oh, no.
He went crazy when he found the letter. He accused me of having an affair. He called me a tramp.
And then he tried to kill me.
He tried to kill us both.
Just help me get out of here, all right? This is our chance. This is our chance, Laura. Our chance. Help me, please.
Leaving everything behind, Laura took off with Luke for a summer on the run and the adventure of a lifetime.
What do you want?
Laura, I want a couple hours of sleep. In something that's a little softer than that midget bathtub. Now, you move over to the other side of the bed. Will you be safe? And just let me sleep here a couple hours, okay?
Not in the same bed with me.
Oh, great. I had to have a honeymoon with Alice in Wonderland.
All right. You lie down. I will get up and get dressed.
You have no heart. You know that? No heart at all.
Look, if we're going to share this room, we're going to share this bed in shifts. You understand?
Sounds great. I love it. I love it. Thank you.
Oh. Thank you. Damn it, Laura, you took the blanket!
They called me at that time the Tragic Princess. And how cathartic to bring this wonderful man into her life who just takes her on an adventure. and makes her Cinderella. It's a wonderful dream.
No, babe. Tonight is real.
And I'm very glad that it is.
I look in your eyes, I see every beautiful thing there is in the world.
Is that what you see?
I see love.
Cinderella, it's midnight. Here come the pumpkins.
Beecher's Corners is this sort of idyllic small town with perfect values. So it was a dream spot, a place to dream and a place to be a dream in.
Women.
Men.
Cows.
Chickens.
Oh, we're going to be together one night. I swear we will, but it's going to be right. It's going to be absolutely right. It's going to be just the way you want it. And I can wait, you crazy lady, but I'll tell you something. I hope you sleep as miserably as I'm going to.
Thank you for trying to understand.
I understand one thing very, very clearly. You may be only 18 years old, but when you kiss me, you are a full-grown woman. And it's driving me out of my mind.
Sweet dreams.
Ha!
I love you. If that helps, Annie.
Barely. Glad you slept well.
Oh, I did. I didn't have any bad dreams last night. In fact, I don't think I dreamed at all. I guess I just felt really safe here. With you, away from poor Charles.
Yeah, well, it's a whole new life for us. Not a very affluent one, however.
Well, how much money do we have left?
We're down to our last few bucks. We're alive, but I'm hungry. I tell you, I am really starving.
You're hungry?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you would never admit that.
I'm hungry, all right?
Good. Help me get this wig on.
Oh, you got it.
Straw everywhere.
Here, is this the front?
I think so.
How's that? That good?
Yeah, I think so. It's fine. Be like Lucy Johnson again.
You look like Lucy Johnson again. Oh, baby, this is not going to last forever. It isn't. The whole game's going to be over as soon as we decode the book, find out who the left-handed boy is. Then we go back. And then you have a lot of decisions to make, you know that. We won't be playing a game anymore. We won't be Mr. and Mrs. Johnson. But I want us to be Mr. and Mrs. Luke Spencer.
Luke is everything that Laura ever wanted. Laura was a person who was always on the outside looking in, who could never quite fit in, who didn't know who her family was or where she belonged, who didn't know her own value. A deeply insecure person. And Luke is, I hate to say it, but the knight in shining armor, who teaches her her own value, teaches her to love herself, teaches her to laugh.
There. How do you like it?
I hate it. It works. I got one question.
What's that?
With this blanket up here, what do I sleep under?
Oh, Luke, it's the middle of August. You don't need a blanket.
Okay, fine with me, but I'll tell you something. I'm not going to sleep in these clothes. I'm sleeping in the buff, girl. And if you have to get up in the middle of the night, go down the hall to the little girl's room, be sure to peek, baby. I got nothing to hide.
Okay, I will give you a sheet in here.
Well.
Uh-huh, and I will use the comforter.
How nice, deep fried as it may be, the girl has a heart.
I slip sometimes.
Well, merci beaucoup, Simone.
You're welcome.
You know, this is really stupid. It is completely unnecessary.
It is necessary. The bathroom is down the hall. We're going to have to change in this room. I don't know about you, but I need privacy.
You got it.
Well, I'll tell you something. If I don't get to sleep, I'm not going to be any good to anybody tomorrow, and we certainly don't want to let down Mom and Pop Calhoun.
No, we certainly don't want to let down Mom and Pop Calhoun.
So, if you don't mind, I'm getting undressed.
I don't mind at all. Thank you. You only do this to make me crazy.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Like hell you don't!
People just call me Hutch. You know, when you're born with a name like Jefferson Smith Hutchins, you know, it's kind of crazy.
Oh, I think that's a nice name.
Really? Well, thank you. I think it's kind of weird myself. I mean, how many people do you know named Jefferson?
Not many.
Yeah.
Me either. I know a few named Smith, though.
Now, will you tell me why you haven't accomplished what you were sent to do?
I can't find out where Luke keeps the black book. So what good is it going to do for me to kill him if I can't get the book back for you?
None at all. All right. Keep in close touch.
Luke, Laura, and Hutch teamed up to solve the mystery of the left-handed boy. The clues led them to the town of Fair Oaks, and Miss Sally Armitage.
Yes.
Are you having trouble finding help?
Well, sure am.
Well, let me take it off your hands. Help has just arrived.
Mister.
My name is Lloyd. This is my wife, Lucy Johnson. That's our friend, Hutch.
Not so fast. Not so fast.
My man in Fair Oaks assures me that
Luke, Laura, and Hutch will be dead by midnight, and I'll have my book.
And remain one of poor Charles' leading citizens.
If he fails, I'll be a man without a country.
I don't want you here, Laura. It's too dangerous.
It's no more dangerous today than it was the first day we
Wrong.
Got here.
It is. Because I'm seeing the left-handed boy tonight. Me, alone. Do you hear that? Me. I don't want you with me, Laura. I do not want you with me anymore. Go home.
Don't do this to me.
Baby, listen, I'll find you. When I get the mess straightened out, believe me, I'll find you. And then...
And then what? Luke? And then what? Luke!
And then I'll find you, and that's it. That's it.
No, no, I am not leaving you. We will leave together.
No. I'll leave when I'm through. You
I
leave
can
now.
I can help you. No.
You leave
I'm
now.
I'm not afraid. I'm not leaving now. I'm not going to get on a bus. No. I want to help you.
I know you do. I know.
I'm not leaving you.
I'll see you.
That's it.
We've got to find him because he's in a lot of danger. He put me on a bus to Port Charles. I got off as soon as I can. He's going to get himself killed. I know he's going to get himself killed.
Okay, not if I can help.
Right? What are we going to do?
Okay, just calm down. Let's think
about... Have you seen him?
Not for a while. Let's think about this rationally, all right? You say Luke says he knows about the left-handed boy and he can decode that book.
That's right.
All right, there's only one thing it could be. It means he's going to meet with the left-handed boy sooner than midnight.
I don't know. I guess that could be it.
Okay, and there's only one place that could be.
Where?
In the magic shop.
Max Hedges, alias Sally Armitage. Number one personnel, huh? Number one hitman.
Luke, are you in here?
Luke's not here, Laura.
I guess not.
I imagine he's at the bar.
Well, then I don't understand. Why did we come here?
To get what I want.
What?
Hold still. Shut up and hold still. Now, we're going to call Luke. But you're not going to see your lover again unless he gives me the gold.
Come on, don't fail me now. Don't fail me.
We don't know about any gold! How much money did Frank Smith pay you to kill us? You're a hitman, aren't you? You're a hitman. And it wasn't by chance that we all landed in Beecher's Corners together.
No, it wasn't. He paid me a lot, but he didn't pay me enough.
Luke solved the mystery, but Hutch was not about to let Luke come between him and a fortune in gold.
Okay, man. Show me.
Here. You buy blue jeans, right?
I buy bulletproof vests.
Now let's get out of this town. It bores me.
Luke was a doomed man before Laura came into his life. I don't think he'd be alive today if it weren't for Laura and her love for him. The fact that she loved and loves him is a miracle in his life.
What else did they do in this movie that seems to rule our entire lives?
I don't remember. Such a long time ago. But I think the man took the woman in his arms and the screen faded to black.
Oh. What a frustrating ending.
I agree. Left much too much to the imagination. But I suppose they lived happily ever after.
I sure hope so. So is this, this how the man did it? The woman?
No. But you knew he was going to.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
No more questions about the past or the future?
No more questions. I just want to be yours now.
Well, then everything's perfect. Because we've got all night.
Get the ticker tape parade, but we did get a police escort, didn't we?
Yeah.
Look, could you spring for a BLT on rye for me? I'm good for it. I'll pay you back later. Okay? Could you
okay,
do that?
Sure.
I want to get something for you. Important.
Like what?
Hey, pushy pushy, chill out. You'll find out. Do you have any cigars?
Yes, of course. Any special brand?
Give me that little thin one there. It looks like that ought to fit.
I beg your pardon?
Right joke. How much is it?
10 cents.
Okay.
You want it in a bag?
Oh, no, we're going to wear it.
You must be crazy.
Oh, you noticed.
Yes. You said you were going to get something for me. I don't smoke cigars.
You don't?
No.
Oh, would you like to start? No, actually, no, this is what I got for you right here. And it's to remind you that, we were married last night. After you get your divorce from Scott, I'm gonna replace that with my mother's wedding ring and make it all legal. Afraid?
Yeah, a little, but I'm gonna be all right. I'll be all right just as long as you won't let go of my hands.
I promise I won't. We'll face whatever it is. And we'll beat it. We'll be together.
Okay. That's all I need to hear.
We've won, you know. We did win. We're not heroes or anything like that, but we won. I know Smith and all his little playmates are going to go to prison.
They're gonna get sent up the river, as they say, right? And we are gonna have a future together. All the way together.
Right.
Would you say the words?
What words?
The words, the word. Come on, girl, the words.
What words?
The wedding vow, the ceremony. Could you say that for me? I, Laura, take thee, Luke.
I, Laura, take thee, Luke.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
I believe you. I believe.
Every man Smith sent after us is dead.
Hold me.
You're safe. You're safe in my arms, and nobody, nobody will ever harm you. Ever.
The lovers returned to Port Charles and were met by harsh reality.
Are you still married to Scott Baldwin? Are you wearing a wedding band?
Yes, I'm wearing a wedding.
Do you still feel really like Mrs. Scott Baldwin?
Of course I'm Mrs. Scott Baldwin. Where is Scotty?
Circus, we're just trying to get some answers.
Look, I'm going to give you a couple of minutes inside.
All right,
with
good.
Luke and Laura and their family.
Great, but hey, hold it.
Only two reporters can go in.
Any question that's out of line and the interview is over. You got it?
Got it.
Laura, you all right?
I'm sorry, I promised to keep hold of your hand.
It's okay.
I think under the circumstances, Luke.
I'm sorry, please, sir. I have to find out that she's okay.
Lee, please.
Mrs. Baldwin, would you care to comment on your relationship with Mr. Spencer?
Oh, hey, now, Luke.
All right, Luke.
Come on.
It's just going to make it worse now. Stop.
Look, you want to answer any? I got the answers to that question, chump. Don't ask her.
Were you back on? Are you still married to Scott Baldwin? Are you wearing a wedding band?
Yes, I'm wearing a wedding.
Do you still feel like Mrs. Scott Baldwin?
Of course I'm Mrs. Scott Baldwin.
You said you're still Mrs. Scotty Baldwin, so that means you're wearing his ring? If you're still Mrs. Baldwin, where is your husband? Why isn't he here with you?
My son is waiting for Laura at their apartment so they can have a little privacy. Now, please, you have your story.
What is that ring you're wearing, Mrs. Baldwin? It's one of those 10-cent cigar bands kids use to promise each other they'll be married one day. Is the cigar band some kind of joke, Mrs. Baldwin?
Is it? Is the paper ring a joke, Laura? The man is waiting for your answer. I'm waiting.
What happened to your wedding ring, Mrs. Baldwin?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I must have lost it. That's enough questions for now,
Mrs.
I think.
Mrs. Baldwin has to make a statement to the police.
What about the cigar band?
That is very personal.
Very personal? Did someone give it to you? Were you born with it?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Please stop.
You mean it's some kind
is
of joke?
Is the ring a joke, Laura?
Are you still married to Scott Baldwin?
Hey, she said she was. Now, isn't that enough for you?
Mrs. Baldwin.
All I have to hear is that she kept her wedding vows, no matter what kind of story you print.
Mrs. Baldwin, have you been faithful to Scott Baldwin?
Yes.
Okay, creep, you got your answer.
It's too bad it broke so easily, isn't it? But then, what do you expect from something so cheap? Wasn't meant to last forever, was it, Laura?
Luke, wait a minute.
One last question,
that's
Mrs. Baldwin.
Your time is up. Come on, let's go.
By the time you read this letter, I'll be gone. It's my turn to run. Only I won't be coming back. I haven't told anyone about this, not Lee, not Brian, not anyone.
Scotty.
I was afraid that they'd try to talk me out of it.
Maybe he Scotty, you're back.
I'm tired of being your joke, and I'm tired of being humiliated in front of Fort Charles by a wife who's a no-good tramp. The apartment is all yours. Your life is all yours, Scotty.
Okay, we keep the kettles under here, and, frying pans up here, or just, you know, wherever there's room for them.
Rose, I'm gonna make you happy. I'm very proud to have this job.
And you're helping me out a lot, too, Luke. And I'm grateful to you for so much more than just this. You managed to accomplish the one thing nobody else seemed to be able to do. You were able to bring Frank Smith to justice.
You're going to regret what you've done, Spencer. One day you're going to regret it with all your heart, I promise you.
Will I?
Someday. Somebody from the organization. I just try and get in touch with you.
Maybe somebody will get both of us. Because I got a feeling if the state doesn't kill you, one of your friends is going to be happy to do it. Or any of the other legion of people who hate your guts. If you'll excuse me, I have to make a statement for the police. And if I were you, I'd start sweating right now, sir, because my statement's going to be a beauty.
I get this feeling I just may be able to make a success out of this diner yet.
Are you joking? Kelly's diner is...
Well, hi, Laura.
Hi. I understand you're working here now.
Who told you?
Ann Logan.
Oh.
He ought to do a good job for you. He learned how to cook this summer.
I learned a lot of things this summer. Excuse me, I have things to do.
Why are you running away from me?
I am not running. I do not run. You know me better than that. I don't run. I just don't want to talk to you. You understand?
No. Why?
I have reasons that satisfy me.
Well, I'm not going to leave it at that. You're going to talk to me. Look, I know you're hurt. I know you're angry. And I know it seems as though I betrayed you, but I
You
didn't.
You did.
Luke, all those reporters were around me. You know how afraid I am of reporters. I got confused.
I'm sorry.
I got scared.
That's too bad. What a shame. Forget it. It's over.
What did I say? It doesn't mean that I don't love you.
Don't apologize, please. Come on. In fact, thank you. Now, me and everybody in town, we all know once and for all who you really love.
You know I love you.
No, I don't.
I'm not going to move from this spot until you put your arms around me and you tell me that you love me.
Go away, Laura.
No.
Look, I'm working here. I haven't got time for this.
This is more important for than any job.
Not to me.
Don't do this, Luke.
You blew it, Laura. You blew it. I don't want to mess this job up, Laura. The summer's not over for me. I'm still broke.
Yeah, well, so am I. Look, I went home for one reason, to ask Scotty for a divorce.
Don't lie to me. You went home after you told all the newspapers that you were definitely Mrs. Scott the Prince Baldwin.
I was. Legally, I still am.
That's not why you said it.
Okay. I couldn't handle the pressure. I made a mistake. I'm sorry. I went home to ask Scotty for a divorce because I want to marry you.
Please don't. Please don't do this. Don't do this to me, Laura.
Luke, please listen to me, please. Just listen. I love you. And I want to be your wife. If you still have me, please face me. Luke, please. Face me. You still love me. I can see it in your eyes.
Luke, I need 2 eggs over easy and bacon well done with English muffin.
You got it, Rose.
What they call a vacuum here.
No, what's all the racket?
This. It's this door. You've got to do something about it.
Yeah, it's absolutely nonsense that she can't get into her own apartment.
Yeah, and you have to do something about the new guy who moved in upstairs in the apartment right above me, because he plays loud music until all hours of the night.
Well, he complains about the noise you make from your apartment. Hey, wait up a minute.
What?
I talked to the girl who's in 202 about the water running so long at night.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, she's just as angry at you about the loud music you play. I don't know what the world's coming to with all these complaints. From now on, though, you do the complaining yourself. Directly.
Laura.
Luke?
You live here?
Yes.
Well, so do I, upstairs.
Upstairs? You're the one with the music?
That's right, and you're the fish lady with the shower, right? I don't believe this.
You know, I've been complaining to the manager about you.
Oh, really? I've been complaining about you, too.
I think you did this deliberately, just to annoy me.
Oh, come on, I'm smarter than that. If I wanted to annoy you, thought you were here, I'd have knocked on your door
What's
and ran every time I went...
shouting about up here? You two had better lower your voices right now. Well, what do you know? Found each other at last.
What?
Together again. I wondered how long it would take you to get the message.
What message?
Wait a minute. You knew all along? You knew who we were?
Listen, I didn't phone you. You just showed up the same as she did. I call it kismet.
I call it a ripoff. This apartment is falling apart, and now I have to put up with him?
That's right. I want her money back. She's moving out.
I'm not moving anywhere. You're moving out.
You're moving out.
I was here first.
Now, don't start that. I've got an ironclad lease.
Well, you rented these apartments under false pretenses. You didn't give us the facts.
Well, a buck is a buck. You know, how did I know the two of you weren't into some kind of arrangement together? Then when all the complaints started, it kind of dawned on me that neither one of you knew that the other one was around. Kind of funny.
I'd laugh if it didn't hurt.
But look here, now that you have found each other, I don't want any hanky-panky or I'll kick you both out.
I'll do all the hanky-panky I want. I got an ironclad lease.
Did you read the small print, honey?
The small print?
Lots.
Dragon lady. Well, you got a real nice place.
Yeah. Well, it's I'm fixing it up, and it's going to be adorable when I'm all through.
Yeah, mine's going to be adorable, too. You're still wet, you know?
Well, I just got out of the shower.
You must sleep in the shower.
Bye.
What do you want from me? Flowers and candy?
No, I want some honest feelings, and you can't seem to handle that.
Look, can we please call a truce before I'm injured for life?
Is that your way of inviting me to dinner?
Yeah. Ain't real romantic, is it? Well, you know, you give a little here, I give a little there. You give a little, I give a little. Pretty soon I'm gonna win.
I think going out to dinner is a good idea. As for your winning, I really wouldn't count on it.
Well, okay, why don't you just, you know, you lead the way, because you are the Lord and Master, and I am but a humble and lowly servant. Can I open the door for you?
Please.
Thank you. May I turn off your light for you?
Please.
May I drive the car for you? Will you buy the gas for me?
Would you both excuse me for a second?
I think we just gave the whole room whiplash.
Good. Want to meet their hearts out.
Want to go for it all the way?
You got it. Lead on.
Put him in the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think we hit this place right between the eyes.
Mm-hmm. It's one of the advantages of being notorious.
Bartender, your wine list. Place my wine.
Yeah, thank you.
We got you.
Don't look now, but my parents just came in. Did you see Laura?
Where?
At the bar with Luke.
So what? Were we supposed to go over and say hiya?
Mm-mm. No, I think they're gonna be nice and give me some space.
Is that new?
Yeah, I guess it is, actually. A lot of things are new with my life now.
Yeah, I guess they are. I thought something was different.
You noticed?
I would have to be blind.
Thank you.
So, you don't mind the spotlight anymore, huh?
I don't. As a matter of fact, I think it's a very good idea that we're out in public. Gives me a chance to talk to you without your yelling or screaming at me.
Well, don't push your luck now. It's still time for me to call for separate checks.
I'm serious. I know how much I hurt you. And I hate myself for it. I also know that I practically destroyed everything that we had together. And it was because of something that you mentioned earlier tonight. Facing people.
Reporters?
No, no. My parents, the Baldwins, Amy, Bobby, everyone who was in that room.
No. Are you telling me that you couldn't face the fact that we had slept together?
That we made love. I lied to everyone, Luke. I even lied to myself. And I almost destroyed you in the process.
Surprise.
Hi.
Anybody mind if we come say hello?
Look, maybe we're interrupting.
No. Be about as welcome as the plague.
No, please. Excuse me. Please join us, please. Doctors. Sit down.
Thank you.
Sorry.
We were just, we were hashing over old times.
You want to come in for a nightcap?
No, I guess not.
Oh. Well, that's okay. I don't have anything to make a nightcap out of anyway. Oh, it's a door. Oh. Ah, thanks. Look, there's one more thing that I want you to understand. The cigar band that you gave me. Look, I know that I threw it away, but I never threw away what it meant. My Laura, take me.
Well,
to be my lawfully wedded husband.
Wedding vows and
to be my lawfully
cigar bands. They go together about like a
big joke.
No, it wasn't a joke to me.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
Laura, look, I'm not handling this all very well, you know, because, because I just don't understand it. I mean, you have been a private obsession of mine for years. And so now it feels like maybe I'm putting it down or something. I'm not putting it down. I really just don't know how to handle all this communication.
Why do you say obsession? That makes it sound so far away, you know? I'm not, Luke. I'm right here.
I hope maybe that someday it'll be right for us. And if it is, then you'll be the first one to know.
And what if it's never right for us?
Then we will still have had the most beautiful summer two people ever had.
Luke.
Hey, look at me. Here I am. I'm standing here. I'm talking in the hallway. And I'm really making a fool out of myself because I want to grab you and I want to hold you and kiss you goodnight and all that. And I'm just trying to make excuses why you can't invite me into your house, apartment, cheap, sleazy dive.
Look, I think we should call it a night. I think it was good, though. I think we made progress.
Yeah, I like that. It makes it sound like a news report. Okay, America, Luke Spencer and Laura Baldwin met tonight for a summit meeting at the Floating Rib, and a lot of progress was made.
You are so crazy.
I know it. Whew. I know. It was a nice evening. And it was good talking to you and listening to you. I like you.
I know how much I hurt you. But I'm gonna wait. And wait. And wait. Till that hurt goes away.
Well, I am a real healthy guy. And my wounds heal fast.
Good night.
Good night.
tired. I'm going to bed.
Listen, you little witch, open the door. On three. One, two, three. Sorry.
Oh, terrific. Now we'll never get it open.
If you ever mess around like that again, I'm going to break your neck.
Like what again?
Oh, like what again? Don't give me like what again. Coming on to that guy at the parade. What do you think you're doing? You're opening yourself up for that guy just to move in on you. Who was the jerk?
Just a guy.
Just a guy. What a shame. Just a guy. This guy doesn't know that you only did that to get to me.
You certainly are sure of yourself, aren't you?
I ought to kill you.
Oh, but then I wouldn't be here.
Laura, listen to me. Don't get mixed up with men you don't know.
I'm not mixed up with anyone but you. You know that.
Well, I have one hell of a way of showing it.
I just want to remind you, I'm here, waiting. Are you ready to go back to Beecher's Corners?
Well, I don't think I've left.
Me either.